students, today's topic is structure and function of mitochondria. The mitochondria was first discovered by Kolliker in 1857. Mitochondria are filamentous or granular cytoplasmic organelles present in the cells. Mitochondria are organelles within eukaryotic cells that produce adenosine triphosphate, that is ATP, which form the energy currency of the cell. For this reason, the mitochondria is referred to as the powerhouse of the cell. Mitochondria vary in size from 0.5 millimicron to 2 millimicron. Mitochondria contain 60-70% of proteins, 25-30% of lipids, 5-7% of RNA, and a small amount of DNA and minerals. Mitochondria consists of two membranes called inner and outer membrane. Each membrane is 60-70 angstrom thick. Outer mitochondrial membrane is smooth and freely permeable to most small molecules. It consists enzymes, proteins, and lipids. It has porine molecules, that is proteins, which form channels for passage of molecules through it. The inner mitochondrial membrane is semi-permeable membrane and regulates the passage of materials into and out of the mitochondria. It is rich in enzymes and carrier proteins. It consists of 80% of proteins and lipids. The inner mitochondrial membrane gives rise to finger-like projections called cristae. These cristae increase the inner surface area of the mitochondria to hold a variety of enzymes necessary for respiration. The inner mitochondrial membrane has minute, regularly spaced tennis racket-shaped particles known as oxysomes or F1 particles. They involve in ATP synthesis. Matrix is a complex mixture of proteins and lipids. Matrix contains enzymes necessary for Krebs cycle, mitochondrial 70S ribosomes, tRNAs, and mitochondrial DNA. Now we can see the functions of mitochondria. Mitochondria is the main organelle of the cell respiration. They produce a large number of ATP molecules, so they are called as powerhouse of the cell or ATP factory of the cell. Mitochondria helps the cells to maintain normal concentration of calcium ions. It regulates the metabolic activity of the cell. Thank you, students. We can meet in the next class with another topic.